Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Hope you are doing well. I am having some data on my network path which I want to copy in my local drive here inside the E drive through the robocopy. And inside the C drive, I have created this folder for the robocopy logs. So I will go to start, I will search here CMD, I will do the run as administrator, I will maximize it, I will go to C drive. And first of all, I will pass the credentials of the source system to the robocopy. For that, I will give this command. This is the IP address of my source system and these are the username and password of my source system. I will hit enter. Now I will give the command robocopy and source path in the inverted commas space destination path in the inverted commas space slash E, which means copy all folders including the empty ones space slash W colon 1, which means it will wait for the 1 second between the retry if the copy fails space slash R colon 2, which means it will wait, it will do the, it will retry the 2 times if the copy fails space slash copy all, which means copy data, attributes, timestamp, security, owner and auditing info of the files. Then space slash dcopy colon dat, which means copy data, attributes and timestamps for directories space slash empty colon 4, means it will copy in 4 thread. If I put nothing, means it will copy in 8 threads, which is the default one space I will give the path for the robocopy logs. I will give the file name also for the logs. So this is my complete command. I will hit enter here. So copy completed. If I go to destination path, you can see here data is available, which means all the data has been copied through the robocopy. If I go to logs folder, you can see here logs has been generated. These are the logs, robocopy logs created during the copy operation. By this way, you can copy the large amount of data also, which can be in TBs also, through the robocopy. And the source or destination path could be network to network, local to network path, or network path to local path. Hope you find this video helpful. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.